Hi there, my name is Jeff and I'm with the Helmet Center, helmetcenter.com. Today, I'm conducting a product review of the Scorpion XO1000. Now, when the Scorpion XO1000 first hit the market, this thing was on fire. It revolutionized helmet design, and it's really laid the groundwork for what's available these days in terms of helmets and what kind of features you're going to get. Even though it's 2 years later, this helmet still has a good following. Sales are very good. It still was one of the more fully featured helmets on the market. So we're going to cover a few of the features, tell you what we like about it, see if we can't help find out if this is the helmet that might work for you. So first and foremost, it is a Snell 2005 and also DOT rated helmet. It does feature a Kevlar composite woven shell, which makes the helmet very, very strong. Now, in terms of weight, because you do have a lot going on inside the XO1000, it is a little heavier, I'll be honest. In a size medium, 4 pounds, 1.5 ounces. So it does break the 4 pound barrier, which on the scale feels a little heavy. However, riding impressions on the bike really weren't as bad as we expected. Actually pretty reasonable in terms of how it traveled through the wind and as far as the impressions that it gave back to the riders who demoed the model. So I would definitely say the weight scared me at first, but after riding it, really pretty decent. Okay, airflow. The helmet actually pushes air pretty well. Most Scorpion helmets, the 400, the 700, are pretty average. You know, they're your good 6.5 out of 7, 7 out of 10, I should say. Pretty average. This one might do a little better than the XO700. I'd be generous at giving it an 8. 7.75 as far as airflow, 7.75 out of 10. As far as airflow and vents on the model here, you do have a vent just above the shield, and you do have a couple of ram air type air intakes here on the top diffuser of the helmet. Pretty easy to operate there with the glove on. It does, the way it operates, it wants to really force that air down into the helmet. On the rear of the helmet, you do have a open and closed setting, which actually is labeled. It's kind of nice to actually know which direction you should be pushing this thing rather than having to guess. But even didn't have the thing on there, you actually can kind of tell the difference when you do put it to the open position, but it's kind of nice. Ventilation, pretty solid on this guy. Other notable features. Now, I'm kind of saving this one for last. There's really two things that make this helmet quite unique. The first is the lever on the side of the helmet. When you lower this, you are in fact deploying a drop-down tinted sunshade. Press it up, takes it away, bring it right back down. For those of you who commute and you're heading to the sun on the way to work or maybe on the way home, that is a lifesaver, a dark smoke tinted drop-down sunshade. It does drop down pretty far. None of the test riders had any trouble with it interfering with their glasses, and it went low enough that no one had trouble looking through the lower edge of the shield. Everyone's eyes were positioned right where they should have been. All right, that's probably the biggest thing on this helmet. But there was something else Scorpion also included on the XO1000. And what that was, on the very bottom of the helmet, after you open up the chin curtain here, you're going to notice there's a little red button in here, so we can show it to you. It's actually a pump, and you can actually pump this, and when you pump it, you're actually inflating air bladders that are hidden behind the cheeks, behind the cheek pads. And what that does is it actually compresses the cheek pads further into your face to help squeeze the fit. There'll be days where I feel like I want to ride a little faster and I want a little more security. I want the helmet to really squeeze my face. I don't want it wobbling. Well, pump the baby up. Just give it a couple pumps inside there, squeezes it in, and there is a release. It'll be on the left side. There's a little silver button right there. You press that, and you'll hear the air release out of the helmet. So pump it up as many times as you need to give you a good squeeze, press the button to release it to remove the helmet. Between those two features, that really revolutionized helmet design. The drop-down visor is now becoming a little more common. You're starting to see it on the new HJC models. Nolan's course is doing it. You have a new Scorpion model coming out in the next few months. That might be worth looking into. It will also feature cheek pads that pump up as well. But the XO1000 is a very nice helmet. It's a very moderate fit. Like I said, it does run about a half size small, but the overall shape of the helmet is moderate. I have a pretty long oval head. I do quite well in this model. The only thing I'd have to say on the downside is just sheer weight, 4 pounds to short of 2 ounces. But on the bike, riding impressions really are quite positive. Scorpion XO 1000, they do give you a 3-year warranty. Scorpion's a great company, really stand behind their products. Should you ever have any trouble, which I doubt you would, but if you do, they are the only company that prints their telephone number anywhere in the documentation. They actually print it on their box. They'll talk to you. They're great people over there. I can go on and on about the XO 1000, but I know the video is going to run a little long here, so if you have further questions about the XO 1000, give us a call here at the store. Telephone number 866-NEW-HELMET. Once again, that's 866-NEW-HELMET. My name's Jeff. Thanks for watching.